How incredible is it that two of our Senate candidates here in the Lowcountry are also on the front lines leading the fight against COVID-19? Every day, with every mask we see or don't see, we are reminded of how our choices affect the health of others and ourselves. The choices we make on November 3rd are going to have a huge impact on the health of our state and of our nation. Are we going to elect leaders who are committed to expanding access to quality, affordable health care? Or are we going to elect politicians who are committed to ending Obamacare and the protections that working families like yours and mine depend on?
I'm a nurse. I believe in science. We have 2,800 South Carolinians dead because of COVID. We have over 191,000 individuals in the United States dead because of COVID. It is time that we stop talking about this and politicizing it, but come together as leaders to decide what we do about it.
So here we are months later, people dying in the hundreds of thousands, and we've paid the ultimate cost.
Right here in South Carolina, more than 75% of our hospital beds are occupied in 15 counties. It's clear that our state isn't ready as we continue to battle the coronavirus.
Well, look, I think that the Democrats are the party that's understanding the severity of this pandemic, that's understanding the need to listen to experts, to listen to science.
Well, I think healthcare should be a right, not a privilege, that we should expand Medicaid, because we have thousands of poor people who just can't afford healthcare.
We are just one of 12 states still denying this coverage, and Lindsey Graham is one of the reasons why. If we expand Medicaid, we can provide health insurance to 214,000 South Carolinians.
If we don't get serious about healthcare during a pandemic, I don't know when we will.
As a state, what we need to do is step up and expand Medicaid so these folks have coverage and access to high-quality medical care to save their lives and to really save them from descending into bankruptcy.
We must expand the Affordable Care Act so that we leave no citizen behind.
If you don't have that card, you know, that insurance card, that health insurance card, when you go into the doctor's office, you're treated almost like a second-class citizen.
One of the areas where we see people pushed into desperate circumstances is when they have health care emergencies that they can't pay for. It's one of those strange root causes of crime that most people just don't think about.
The great tragedy during this pandemic is that people are losing their health insurance at precisely the time that they need it the most.
In fact, more than one in five South Carolina adults living in rural areas of this state have no health insurance. That's a staggering statistic.
What I'm hearing from constituents that there's been a big pullback in healthcare services in rural areas. We've got to turn the tide and make sure that we're expanding services, not pulling services back.
Because it takes at least an hour, like in my district, for someone to get to the nearest hospital from Eddysville.
Four of our rural hospitals have closed in the past few years. Eight counties don't even have a general hospital to speak of.
Choices for women are constantly under attack. Their reproductive freedoms are constantly under attack in South Carolina. I want a state senate. I want a state government that doesn't do that.
In South Carolina, maternal mortality rates and infant mortality rates are high. It's unacceptable.
And so when looking at our opportunities in this election, it's either, you know, individuals who are trying to take away your health care or individuals who are trying to protect your health care.